All right, we're here with Josh from the IE team. Josh, tell us a little bit about yourself. What do you do over in IE land?
So I am a program manager on the Internet Explorer developer outreach team. So we're in dev marketing. And our job is to help developers develop for an interoperable web, and particularly, obviously, with relation to Internet Explorer.
And you've got a great site for this, and it's the one-year anniversary of this site. Tell us about the site.
So the site is Modern.IE, and we're very excited. We've been in operation for a year now, and in that year, we've had a lot of people come to the site and take advantage of the tools and the learning resources, et cetera, that we have on the website.
And what is the main purpose of the website? What is the main thing that you help people do?
So the main thing that we help people do is we help them test for an interoperable web. Mm-hmm. And so that includes a lot of tools to help them do static analysis of their website, as well as we've got virtual machines so that if they don't have a particular version of Internet Explorer or they want to test on a different operating system, they can do that. In fact, we've got 90 plus different configurations of virtual machines.
So do you have to be on IE? Can you be on other platforms to use this?
So you can absolutely use these on any platform. My favorite demo to do at a conference is I'll ask them to give me their phone.
Yeah.
And I will test their website on their phone using my tools.
Yeah. Very
and
nice.
So that's a lot of fun. And then, you know, regardless of what operating system they're running, we have a virtual machine for them. Mm-hmm. So if they're running, actually, I can very quickly go take a look at, you know, a lot of these different virtual machines. I want to go touch this screen.
Yeah, I know. We have the Perceptive Pixel, but we haven't put it in here yet.
I have a couple of touch machines and a couple of non-touch machines, and my non-touch machines are covered in fingerprints.
It's getting harder. Every day it's getting harder.
So let's say that you are a Mac developer and your preferred virtualization layer is Parallels.
Yeah.
That's great. We have XP and IE6 machine for you in case, God forbid, you have to test for that.
Hopefully you never have to use that.
Never have to use that. However, there are some potential bits and bobs in large enterprises, particularly government and banks that are using IE6.
Yeah.
We're working on that. In fact, that is another part of what my team does is IE6countdown.com will take you out to this site, and you can see here we are down to 4.4% IE6 usage worldwide.
Yeah.
And in fact, in the US, it's 0.2%, which we're really excited about. Mm-hmm. The shining star is Norway up here.
Nice.
0.0.
Nice.
We're all excited about that. We have some issues in certain parts of the world.
Yeah.
But we're getting there.
Well, I see one part of the world that has a pretty significant
issue. A little bit lit up there, yes.
Yeah.
However, I was talking to the IE lead in China, and they've got some, you know, things that they're working on.
Yeah.
XP going out of support is going to help there because a lot of their enterprises are going to upgrade.
Yeah.
Their governments are going to start upgrading, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
So IE6, you know, we are trying to kill that off. IE7 Vista, all the way up to, we've got virtual machines for Windows 8.1 and IE11.
Okay.
So regardless of what version of Internet Explorer on what operating system, and regardless of what operating system you happen to be running on, and what virtualization layer you're running on, we've got a virtual machine for you. So if you're Windows, let me go back here to Windows and Hyper-V. So we've got all these Hyper-V images out here. Now these are 90-day not activated Windows instances, which means that they are for you to do testing with.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the end of those 90 days, you come back and you have to come download another one.
Yeah.
But it's a small tax to pay in order to be able to develop for a interoperable web. That's one of the many tools that we have out here. We also have the site scanner, which does static analysis of your sites.
All right.
And so, What's a site?
Pointer.org is the site that I used to work on.
Okay, and how do you spell that?
POYNTER.org.
Pointer. Now you're not going to be like upset about this.
No, I won't be. No, it's a journalism think tank, and I'm sure they'll be fine with wanting to make themselves better. That is what they do. So.
All right. So let's try this one more time, and I believe I need to do the pointer.org. There we go. So it is pulling up. What website did that pull up? Yep, pointer.org. So there's a couple of things that it's found here. It's interesting because this is different than what the scan was before the show.
Yeah.
But frameworks and libraries here, we'll actually see here that they're using 1.8.2 of jQuery, of jQuery UI.
Mm-hmm.
And they could move up to 1.8.2.4 with no code changes on their own site.
Yeah.
All they would have to do is include a different file, and they're done.
Okay? Nice. Okay.
We can tell them move to the latest, but that's going to require a great rewrite of their site.
Yeah.
And we're not telling people to do a whole lot of extra work. We're saying this will get you up to the latest and greatest.
Here's how to be more compatible.
Here's how to be more compatible, write a more interoperable website. And the latest and greatest there, the reason they're iterating is they've got a lot of code changes and fixes.
Yeah.
You know, so there's security issues, there's compatibility issues, there's other things that they have found as they go through. We also recommend here for them a responsive website. Mm-hmm. They're doing browser detection in a couple of places, so we can actually go take a look and see on line 320, they're looking for the user agent. We recommend that people do feature detection rather than browser detection.
Yeah.
And so if you ask if this feature exists and then try it, rather than doing a browser detection, that's going to result in a much more durable website.
Yeah.
There's a lot of other things that we suggest, such as flip ahead. We'll look for if they're able to take advantage of flip ahead, touch first browsing.
And touch first browsing, what are you actually looking for there?
So what we're looking for there is, are they using pointer events? Are they using gestures? Are they using those types of things for their navigation?
Yeah.
And for their interaction with the user. Mm-hmm. We're also looking for things such as the flip ahead. So for example, if I go to my blog here, joshholmes.com, I have flip ahead turned on here, so I'm able to browse down through, and I've got a number of things in here. So I've got my double tap, which zooms to my to here. But you know, with flip ahead, I don't know if you've seen this feature in the immersive browser here, but I can go scroll all the way down to the bottom and go find that next.
Yeah.
Or I simply swipe ahead.
Nice.
And then I can just swipe ahead again. And then I can just swipe ahead again.
And that's going through your pages.
And
right?
So, yeah, exactly. So what that's doing is it's looking for, in the header of my page, is looking for a link, relationship equal next. Mm-hmm. Now, this is also a best practice for SEO.
Yeah.
Because Google and Yahoo and Bing and everybody, they all look at that link, relationship equal next, and says, this content relates to this content, and that's the next one in the progression. So let's look at all these as one. And we'll send people to the first page rather than sending them three pages deep.
And if you're on an individual story that's got multiple parts, you could use it there too.
So New York Times is using the link relationship equal next for articles. And so because they've got them broken up into multi-page articles. Mm-hmm. Same exact code.
And that would be nice if everyone used that.
Everyone did that, that'd be great. And so this is one of the things that we look for in our modern.ie scans, okay? One of many things that we're looking for. Now, this scanner is also, as a by the way, you can actually see right here, there's an open source version available on GitHub.
Nice.
So go download this. It's Apache 2 license. It's written in Node.js.
Okay.
We are looking forward to seeing people download this and fork it, give us lots of feedback, you know, dig into the code. We've got over 100 people have forked it already. Mm-hmm. We're looking for many more than that, because we really want this to be a robust, comprehensive search engine, or static analysis engine.
So tell us how this is different from Rethink.IE.
So Rethink is the kind of the Uber brand that we're looking at. Rethink is, we want people to rethink how they do websites.
Yeah.
We want people to rethink what's possible on the web. And so as a result, there's a lot of things that we're doing in our game-changing experiences, such as Hover. Mm-hmm. Do you remember Hover? Did you ever play Hover? Mm-hmm. So we've rewritten Hover from the DirectX demo to be a WebGL demo, so we can actually go play this directly here in browser. This is something that was absolutely not possible even 3, 4, 5 years ago.
Yeah.
And so now, you know, this is all in browser, and you know, we can go play, you know, quite a bit. There's a ton of other things that we're doing here in Internet Explorer to really help us rethink what's possible on the web.
Yeah.
So that's what Rethink is about. Modern.ie is a set of tools that's going to help you get there.
Yeah, and so one of the tools I wanted to talk a little bit about is Browser Stack.
Yes.
Tell us what Browser Stack is and how we use it on Modern.ie.
So Browser Stack is a great partner. Browser Stack is a virtualization platform, and actually, back up on that. they are a remote desktop as a service, effectively.
Yeah.
Okay. So, but they have a tremendous range of different devices and browsers that you can remotely log into. So, for example, they've got Windows 8.1 and Chrome 27 or Internet Explorer 11, mm-hmm. right? They also have an Android device. They also have an iPad. They also have a Surface. They also have all types of different devices, and you can remotely go access those. And you can just log in as if you're sitting there with the physical device and just use it as a remote desktop.
Yeah.
Or, and this is what the SharePoint team actually does, they actually have done a tremendous amount of automation against the devices, and Browser Stack offers them an API so they can remotely and automatically run their tests. Mm-hmm. And so when any developer is going to check in code into SharePoint, they have to run their entire test suite against the code that they're going to check in,
yeah.
and they do that by automating it up against Browser Stack. And that gives them a great range of different devices. On the screen here, you can see we've got a little bit of integration. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Mm-hmm. What we're using is we're using their API, and you can see the screenshots that we're pulling back from the from Browser Stack. And so you can see here Windows 8 and Opera 12, obviously Windows 8 and IE 10, Windows 8 and Chrome 7. We've got an iPhone 4S, an OS X Mountain Lion.
That's awesome, I love that.
And so we're able to, quickly go take a look and see, oh, this is what it would look like on an iPad.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is how the page renders, and how is that different from the Android? And so immediately, just from this level, I can see that Firefox 20 has got much bigger borders.
Yes.
You know, and then the
Opera too, it's kind of floating out in the middle there.
Yep, absolutely. And so they, Opera, I would go to, if I were Pointer, go take mm-hmm. a look at Opera
yeah.
and do some testing with Opera
yeah.
based on this here.
Yeah.
And the rest of these, I'm going to go look at those screenshots and I'm going to see, is that something that I actually care about?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it not something that I care about?
Probably the most important thing, is it breaking my site? And
yes.
Is it still usable?
Probably the most absolutely.
Important. Yeah.
And now there are people that are like pixel perfect,
yeah.
right? You get a designer involved, and that designer, if they're good,
yeah.
are typically, they want to be pixel perfect.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah.
And so they've designed something, and if it's not exactly the right font, if it's not exactly the right look and feel, mm-hmm. they're going to get frustrated. Now, one of the things we've done that's kind of fun is that in addition to the scan, we'll actually take all of those screenshots and we're going to bring those up in a fun PDF here and give it a second here to finish rendering out. And you can see we're actually using the screenshots
nice.
From the service in that PDF.
Very nice.
And this is a big high-res PDF, so you can print this out as a poster and put this on the wall at your office, really impress your boss. And just have a little fun with it.
Yeah, that's really nice. I love this. Great. So where do people go to get started?
So where you go to get started is go to modern.ie.
Okay.
So http://modern.ie. And this brings you to this site here where we've got the scanner. We've got the tools such as the all the virtual machines. Mm-hmm. We've also got the Browser Stack integration. Also through Browser Stack, you can get 3 months free.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Browser Stack is a paid service. It's not
yeah.
a tremendous amount of money. They've got all the details on browserstack.com for how much it costs. But we have an exclusive 3 month free offer if you come to modern.ie and sign up through modern.ie. We also have a lot of other great learning and material here on modern.ie, but go to modern.ie, that's where you get started.
Excellent. Thanks so much.
Not a problem.